So you want to learn about the aquaculture of salmon? Well, today we're going to get an inside look and take a tour of the State of California Department of Fish and Wildlife Nimbus Fish Hatchery and learn all about salmon fish farming. Well, I'm here in the summer and the fish ladder is empty. One of the first things you see is this fish crowder. The purpose of the crowder is to direct the fish into the fish hatchery. On the other side of this wall, I'm told there's an elevator that'll bring the fish into the hatchery building. But on further inspection, I notice that the elevator also doubles as an electric anesthesia unit. Here, Greg and I are discussing the placement of the fish in relationship to the different electrodes. Greg is demonstrating how the fish biologists handle the Chinook salmon as they come into the hatchery. First, they experience the electrical stunning, then they get their gills cut by this device. The purpose is to bleed the fish out, which is also called exsanguination. They're also followed with a percussion stunning step using these mallets. Things are pretty quiet right now, but in the winter, this place is busy. Cue the winter run Chinook salmon fish ladder montage. The Nimbus Fish Hatchery is involved in the conservation of the Chinook salmon. The majority of these Chinook salmon were spawned right here at the fish hatchery. The Chinook salmon run up the American River and return to spawn at the Nimbus Fish Hatchery and complete their life cycle every single year. After the fish elevator is lowered, the crowder will direct the salmon into the fish hatchery. Once the doorway is closed, they'll power on the electrical stunning device, which will allow them to handle the salmon in a safe manner for both the fish biologist and the salmon. What you see here is steelhead trout, which are spawned after the Chinook salmon. They'll fin clip those fish and then return them back to the river. A number of fish will be kept for spawning. I'll make another fish video covering fish spawning of steelhead trout at the Nimbus Fish Hatchery. I think this is a good time to remind you that Chinook salmon are Pacific salmon, like the sockeye salmon, and once they've spawned, they'll complete their life cycle and die. Paired male and female Chinook salmon will be put in the central table for spawning, while the remaining Chinook salmon will go to feed people and be processed and sent to local food banks. One of the projects I'm really passionate about is increasing animal welfare on fish farms. I'm working with fish biologists to evaluate the use of a non-penetrating captive bolt stunner, making comparison about the efficacy of its use against the mallet. Once the fish have been properly exsanguinated, they'll make their way to the spawning table. The colors on some of the Chinook salmon, also known as king salmon, are just spectacular. Eggs are removed from female salmon and checked for proper texture before sperm, also known as milt, are added to the eggs. We'll be right back. After the fish eggs are fertilized, the now salmon zygotes will be given a few minutes to harden in a water bath. After the salmon eggs are hardened, they're soaked in a solution of iodine to disinfect and sterilize them for pathogens such as fungus. Once a few minutes have passed, the bucket is rinsed with fresh water. By May, not much is going on in the fish hatchery, except for a few hundred thousand steelhead. The steelhead trout, unlike the salmon at the Nimbus fish hatchery, are reared in these vertical incubators, which are also called heath trays. After the steelhead trout hatch and the sac fry have absorbed their yolk sac, they're ready to go on feed. They're put in these boxes to closely monitor their feed intake during this critical period. Once the fish biologists are comfortable that the steelhead trout have transitioned to the feed, they're added to these large raceway tanks. I don't think I'd do very well at guess the number of fish in a tank game. 107,000? 78,000? Just when I thought there were a lot of fish in the fish hatchery, they had to take me over to the nursery. Greg is explaining how they have to use different sized screens and make incremental transitions as the fish get larger. Let's see what else we could find. A regenerative blower? What are these hoses for? Oh, they're for the airline. Greg's going to connect one to show us how they work. Here's where it attaches. Makes sense to me, pretty slick. Can't call yourself a fish hatchery if you don't have fish nets. Here are the fish jars. These jars function as upwellers, where the water enters the bottom and is flushed up to the surface. Let's cue that Chinook salmon wintertime fish hatchery montage. So after the salmon eggs have been disinfected in the iodine solution, they're added to the egg jars. And in the wintertime, there are egg jars everywhere. The egg jars are functioning properly when just enough water is flushing through, causing a nice tumbling effect. This tumbling action forces the bad eggs, which are the white ones, up to the surface. This ends up being a lot of work because each one of those egg jars have to be picked by a fish biologist to remove those bad white eggs. Not removed, those bad eggs develop water molds and fungus, which can affect the rest of the embryos in the jars. Aren't sac fry adorable? If you've ever been to a fish hatchery, the one thing that always stands out is the amount of food. There's diets to feed all life stages of fish, from the powdered diets for the small fish to bigger bags of feed for our smolts and juveniles. Check out these hoppers. You guessed it, more feed. It's at this point the fish biologists spend almost all their time feeding fish and cleaning tanks. A At some point, the fish get too large for those indoor tanks and they gotta be transitioned to the outdoor raceways, where the Chinook salmon start acting like salmon. If you wanna see what happens to them after they've entered in the outdoor raceway, you're gonna wanna check out this video right here. For UC Davis Aquaculture and the California Department of Fish and Wildlife Nimbus Fish Hatchery, I'm Dr. Jackson Gross.